I would like to take this opportunity to say a few things in English for all the people who are not Greek and who are interested in what is happening on Andros, either because they are visitors or even more so if they have chosen to have a second home on the island. The environmental problems in Andros are many. With one being the most important, according to my opinion, but it can be assessed that it is the most important if we quantify the impacts. And this is none other than the installation of industrial scale wind farms on the island. I would like to stress here that the term wind farm is a euphemism, because there's nothing compared to a natural farm, to this industrial situation where we have thousands of tons of reinforced concrete and machines that tower up to 100, 150 or 200 meters into the air. This is completely off the scale of the Cycladic landscape and is completely destroying and undermining. The problem becomes even worse if you take into account the fact that we have already at the moment one such industrial wind farm with five machines 150 meters tall in the southern protected area of Andros in the Korthi area, where the installation was actually on one of the designated footpaths of Andros. So the contradiction between the one type of soft, let's say, development of wandering, of hiking tourism is in sharp contrast with this development, and we can see it. Just to give you a few pieces of information regarding this installation, there is a long-going legal activity against it. The actual farm, or let's call it industrial installation from now on, is just 500 meters from a nest of a species of eagle that is protected and that should have 3.5 to 5 kilometers radius from an active nest. The same is so for the actual footpath, which is should be protected because it is a public property and a public resource. These are just some indications of how this huge problem of this energy transition is actually taking place in situ, on the areas where it is being implemented. Similarly, in the north of Andros, we have already lost all the court cases, which means that this project is ready to start at any moment now, for 53 wind turbines of a similar size that are even closer to the eagle's nest, the other pair. Let me just tell you that Andros has only three pairs of this protected species of eagle, and that the aim was to preserve, if not enhance, this population. And what is actually happening is that it's being threatened to move away from the island, because Andros has no other areas where it can alternatively nest and feed. So we have a legislative situation where the protected areas are not actually being protected, and some people are fighting against this reality for decades now, and we have reached the level of the European Court, but this is a very long discussion to get into this matter. To complete the picture, we have also another project of wind turbine installation in the central part of the island, and namely above Chora, above Batsi, and above Gavrion. There are still some court decisions that are pending for this issue, but it is as good as approved, because all the facts that we have so far point to the direction that it is going to go ahead. So in total, we have already more than 100 such machines that have gone, that have gotten the green light to be installed on Andros. This will completely change the landscape of the island and completely alter its profile and character regarding all kinds of human presence from now on. That's why I think it is a very important issue to share with all the people who may not be well informed or at all informed regarding this matter. You can, following this presentation, this short presentation, I urge you to write some questions in English that I would be more than happy to answer to anyone who would like to know more. It's also interesting to put this whole local issue into a global perspective. It's not as if we care about the wrong land planning, or actually I should be saying the total absence of land planning regarding such big machines that are of no comparison to anything that Greece has seen so far, let alone the islands that are even more fragile ecosystems and more sensitive landscapes. This energy transition is happening at a time that many things are being put in, that we have to judge again, I would like to say. This energy transition is based on the use of natural gas as a base load production of energy. And given the global developments, this is becoming more and more expensive, and hence the European economy as a whole is becoming less and less competitive because of this fact. So what is happening in Greece in particular is that we are taking part in a most active way in this energy transition that, again, I stress, has to be reconsidered, has to be reevaluated given what we have now. And we have to weigh the pros and cons. We have to weigh what to invest, how much money to invest, what do we get in CO2 reduction, and what are the local implications that also have not only CO2 consequences but other environmental consequences that may be equally or even more important. So it is really sad for Greece and the islands in particular that we are following with extra speed and less protection and less caution a model that should be at least discussed at this juncture. And so there's a lot to lose if we don't put some kind of brake on this development. And if nothing else, we should apply the precautionary principle and say that, okay, at least the areas that are protected and have some natural value that is unique shouldn't be sacrificed for something that we don't know how much and if at all effective it is. Thank you.